Hello everyone. In this class, we will discuss about the basics of the sheet metal components. As all of you know, that a sheet metal is nothing but that is a component which has a thickness greater than 0 and less than 12 millimeter. That one we will call it as that is sheet metal component. By using these sheet metal components, we will design some components that is sheet metal components. Sheet metals. This, how we will do this fabrication, that is without using the lathe, by some other means we will produce, that is by bending and stamping. By such method we will produce the sheet metal components. Right here, whenever you are starting with the CAD here, first we have to set the sheet metal parameters, then we can go on designing the sheet metal component. To start with that one, first you go to start, then mechanical design and generative sheet metal design. Here you can name the part what you are going to design. After naming, just you click on OK. Here first we have to set the sheet metal parameters. That means what is the thickness of the sheet metal and what is the default bend radius. For that, here by using this walls tab, here you can see that is the sheet metal parameters, or you can go for insert. Here also you can set the sheet metal parameter. Anywhere you can set. Just I will click on this sheet metal parameters. When you click on this, a dialog appears, that is for to mention the thickness of the sheet metal and the default bend radius. This one, this represents the thickness. This is the default value for entire the sheet metal component. Here I will take it the default value 1.5 mm thickness I will take, and the default bend radius. This represents the inside bend radius of the sheet metal. Here I will take it as 2 mm. After setting this, then you can go for the design. And in this sheet metal parameters, you can here only you can decide the which type of relief you can give. That means whenever you fold or unfold the sheet metal, at that time if you are not providing the relief, means there is a chances it will intersect. The edges of the sheet metal component will intersect. That's why we have to give some relief so that the components do not intersect. For that purpose, we will give the what is this reliefs. That also depending with minimum, with no relief also you can give, or square relief. Here you can see that is at the end of the sheet metal where they are intersecting. Here we are doing the square relief. In the same manner, round relief. You can give all these values, and you can modify these L1 and L2 values. Here you can see this is the L1 value, and this is the L2 value. You can mention that is you can, if you want more value, that is 2 mm or 3 mm, you can change the L1 and L2 values. Right? These are the bend extremities to avoid the intersection of the sheet metal components when you fold or unfold. But in this here you can see this is the fold or unfold icon. When you click on this, if you are not providing the relief, then the sheet metal component will be intersected. For that, to avoid that, we are providing the reliefs. Okay, different reliefs are there. We can give, we will discuss whenever you are joining, we are designing the sheet metal components. Then here you can see this is the bend allowance. That is here, the bend allowance, that is K factor. That is the K factor. It is the ratio between the distance from the neutral fiber to the upper surface of the sheet metal part. Here we can change this also. That is depending on our design, we can change the bender. Right? This is setting the sheet metal parameters. If we set, then when you are designing directly, it will take the round relief. Or when you, by default, it will take minimum with no relief. For not changing means the default it will take minimum with no relief. Just click on OK. we have set it, that is a sheet metal thickness and the bend radius we mentioned. Now first we need to create a wall. This is the first step, that is the base wall we have to create first. But maybe you just click on any plane by using the sketch you can create, or after clicking on this then select the plane on which plane you want to set. That also you can do. Here it will ask for, that is profile. That means when it is asking for profile, you just click on the sketch, right? Then select the plane. Then whatever the required sketch, you can draw it and click on OK. You will get the base wall. Or first I will select the plane, then I will select the sketch. Right, then I will sketch one rectangle, centered rectangle. This is with some dimensions. After that, just exit the workbench. Click on the exit workbench. Then just click on the wall. Click on the wall. Just I click on wall. Here you can see this is, here this one you can see, that is sketch at extreme position. That means the thickness will be on one side only. Above this plane, the whole thickness will come. When you click on this, I given 1.5 mm thickness. That means it will be from the neutral axis it will take. Right? That is 0.75, then 0.75, like this. When you click on this, half of the thickness above this plane and half below the plane. You can take any one. That I will take this one, then click on. Right, this is the base wall. We call it as, this is base wall. Then you can create the wall on edges. If you create the another wall on this edge, for that purpose you will go for the wall on edge. Right here, when you click on this wall on edge, then type which type you will. Here you can see, that is one is sketch base. That means you will select the edge and you will select the face. On that face you will sketch. Or automatic means when you just click on this edge, it will automatically consider. You can see this is the by automatic. Here you can change the height. This is the height. You can change, I will reduce it to 100. Then you can see this is now height is reduced. Then angle also you can change. That is with respect to inner surface. This is the angle between inner surface of this base plate and inner surface of the wall on the edge definition. Right? Here if you change this 130, then you can see this is how it changes. This is wall on the edge. Or if you change this to 30 degree, then you can see. This is, by changing this, you can change the angle. Just for this one I will maintain now, that is 90 degrees. Then you can see here here no clearance. That is, no clearance means it is on which edge you will create, on that edge only it will be created. Otherwise if you take this one, when you that is when you take the monodirectional, then you can increase the clearance value. Just you observe the sketch, that is a sheet metal component here. When you go on increasing, the length increases in the x direction, that is in the horizontal direction only it will increase. This is monodirectional. Suppose if you take the bidirectional, then if we increase the value, it will increase in x direction, that is in horizontal direction as well as in the vertical direction. You can observe here, in both direction it will increase. See here, this is you are getting the round corner, but if you take monodirectional, then you can see that is only increasing in horizontal direction. For that purpose you are using the monodirectional and bidirectional. Then the relief also we discussed. That also we can discuss. Now we can see here extremities. And one more, here length type. Here this is length type. Here it is selected is this represents. This is the from where it represents. That is the length type is that is from the bottom of the base wall. This is the vertical distance from the lower face of this base wall to the extreme edge of the wall on which you, the wall is created. Right? This is the extreme edge of the wall and this is the lower face of the base wall. If we change this one, then second one, from the upper face of the base wall to the extreme edge, this is the second one. Similarly, if you select this, if you're selecting this one, then that represents this is the height of the wall from the start of the this is a bend. From year to year it represents, this is start of the bend, right? Here you can see this is start of the bend to the extreme edge of the wall. That is the length type. That is depending on which type you can select any one. And when you select this one, last one, the intersection of this base wall and the wall on which edge you are creating. From that point, it will take the height of the wall. This is the length type, right? Then extremities. You can see here extremities. That means that is here to the length of the base wall it is creating. But when you take the, offset it by minus 10. Now we can preview. See here. Now you can create it for any length. That means from the reference line, you can select it. Or if it's, you can select one more plane. Okay, you can select here. That is create a plane. From which surface I will select this one. And I will move to certain distance. Okay. Then this is for up to this plane it is created. Or if you want, that is, I want this right limit. First one I given the offset. For the second one I will create a plane. At some distance. I will use distance as 40. Right? Now we can see up to this plane you can create. Right? Thereby either you can give the offset value, that is left side, and the right side also you can give the offset value, or you can create a plane at a particular, that is at a required distance. Then for that distance you can create the wall and the edge. This is related to extremities. And here one more thing, that is here the bend parameters. Here with no relief given, you can observe at the end there is no relief. There is no relief. Here also there is no relief. That's why when you click on here, then you can select the relief. This is without bend, with bend you can, you are doing. To select the bend parameters, right, select this one or select the type. I will select the minimum with the square relief. Minimum with the square relief, then preview. Here you can see this is at the left extremity I selected. But for the right extremity, you can see here only left extremity I selected the square relief. For right extremity, I will select one more thing, that is round relief. Here you can see, then now it is changing. Just to preview and work it. This is how we can give the bend parameters. Left side I maintain the square relief, right side I maintain the round relief. Right, this is how we will create the wall, the base wall and the wall on edge. then again, then if suppose if you want some other that is with the different bend reliefs, okay, just I will create again, I will select the wall on edge, I will select this edge, okay, here just to change this to mono directional or no clearance, and I will extremities, I will select the left minus 10 mm and right also I will select minus 10 mm. Just to get the relief like this. If you are up to this edge, if you are creating means, then it is not possible to create the relief. It is not possible to provide the relief. That's why I will offset this one, then preview, right? Now we can see there is a gap of 10 mm here, 10 mm here. Now, square relief and round relief, that one is completed. Next, we will go for the next relief. For the left extremity, I will select the, what is this? This linear shape. And the preview. Now we can see here how it looks. Okay, just I will do. Okay, this is how the relief it will looks. That is when you select one, we selected here. You can see this is the square relief, this is the round relief, then this is the linear relief. Okay, here you can see this is how it looks, linear relief. And it, at this point, we have not mentioned anything. For that, I will take another relief. Okay, again, I will go for, that is, I will double click on, go for part body, this one, I will double click on this. Then go to, that is bend parameters again. Left extremity is over, that is linear we selected. Come to right extremity, again go for new one. Then that is maximum bend relief. I will take it maximum bend relief. Then preview, okay. Now we can see this is how it looks. It was before only, it was not there, this extended portion. Now this is with respect to maximum relief, right? And this one is the linear relief, right? And this one, this is round relief. And the last one, that is the square relief. And many are there. Again, you can check, you can select and you can change the different reliefs. Right here, many are with the first one is minimum with no relief. Then square relief, then round, then linear, then tangent, then maximum bend, then closed, then flat joint. These type of bend parameters we can give to the left or to the right side of the bend. Right. Then this is related to automatic wall. Suppose if it is the sketch based, then how to complete that? Just we'll start with that one. Right here I will create, that is I will go for wall on edge, select that. Then I will select the edge of this plate. Okay, now it is again, it is automatically creating the wall. I will change it to sketch based. I will change it to sketch based. Now it will ask for the profile, from which profile. I will select the, I will go for a sketch, right? Then I will select this face, just zoom it and select the face. Select this face. Then click on this. Now we can create. Now we can create this normal. Just click on this normal. Then zoom it. Just I will create one rectangle. Just I created a rectangle. Then go for constraint. Select this line. And this line, just give coincidence. So selected ground one. Edge of this one and edge of this one, right? Just I create whatever the shape you need, either if we, and you can see the here also, that is I will make a corner here, whatever the shape it is required, you can do that. Then after creating this sketch, just you exit this, then you can create the wall on the edge. Whenever you're creating, I selected this edge, and when you're creating the sketch, it should be intersecting with the other side of this edge, not this one. It should be intersect with other side, this line. See here, that is depending on our sketch, it is created. Then you can give, click on OK. This is based on the, what is this, that is based on the sketch. Here, no relief here given. On either side, that is left or right side, there is no relief of given. If you want to give, again just click on this wall on edge with bend, right? You can give here, that is whatever the required. I will select the left also, I will select the round, and the right also I will select the round relief. After selecting, now you can see here, that is it is changing, that is it is providing the relief. Just click on preview. Okay. This is how we will create the wall on edge by using the sketches, right? That is, whenever you're creating the wall on edge, you will get either sketch based or automatic. When it is automatic, just only need to give the height, then the angle and clearance mode if it is required. That is either in a horizontal direction when you select the monodirectional, or if you select bidirectional, horizontal as well as vertical, it will change. When there is no clearance, they will select the first one. This is related to clearance. And when it is extremities, that is to limit the size of the wall on the edge to the left side or to the right side, or by that is by mentioning the offset value, or by creating the plane also, we can limit the extension of the wall. And we can select whatever the bend parameter, that is reliefs that is required at the end of this edge, that is where it is bending. Right, this is basic steps that is we will use whenever you are designing the sheet metal components. We will continue in the next class some other basics that is related to sheet metal. Thank you.